So one thing we should be aware of when assigning a static IP address to a server is that it can potentially cause an IP collision. And that's because DHCP servers are not aware of devices that have static IP addresses. Okay, so the introduction of static IP addresses introduces the risk of collisions because DHCP servers do not recognize devices configured with static IPs and may inadvertently assign these addresses to other devices. So we're going to see how to assign a static IP address to a server without causing collision. So first we need to go to our router's management page. The address depends on your router. It differs among different routers, but usually it's one of these. If I check the IP address of my computer, I can see it here. So chances are that for me, the first option is going to work. And I know it will because I checked it before. Now, this is going to look different for different router manufacturers, but the idea is always the same. First, we need to sign in. And once again, it might look a bit different, but there should be a category similar to this one, local network. That's where we can configure our DHCP settings. If we show advanced, we can see under the DHCP settings, the DHCP start address and the DHCP end address. So these two define the range of IP addresses that can be assigned dynamically by the DHCP server. The idea is to choose something that's outside this range for our static IP addresses. So let me SSH to the server that I want to configure. And let's list the network interfaces on the server. And we can see that apart from the loopback interface, we only have one network interface here, this one, and it's called ENP0S3. Next, we will configure the server's networks using Netplan. If we list the files in this folder, we can see that we only have one of them. In your case, you might have more than one, or it might have a different name, but this is the default. Let's edit the Netplan configuration by editing this file. And here is how it needs to look like. As you can see, it's very similar to what we currently have, and only the two last lines are different. This is the name of the network interface. I already have it written here, and I'm not going to change it. So I'll only copy these two last lines and paste them to my file instead of the DHCP4. And now we need to replace this access with the actual IP address that we want. So let's take another look at our router, and I'm going to copy the first three digits. These are going to be the first three digits of our IP address. As for the last number, the fourth one, it can be anything you want, apart from 1 or 255. And also make sure that it's not in the DHCP range. So for me, I have to pick something that's lower than 100 or bigger than 249. I'll just go with 33. Let's save the file, and we now need to apply the Netplan configuration. We should first run this line, but since I'm using SSH, I'm going to skip it and just apply the configuration right away. And of course, our SSH connection was lost. So let's open a new tab in our terminal, and let's SSH to the server using the new IP address.